Do I want to use one of the fancy glasses?
Yes.
Well, there's a reason why I chose it. Look what's on it.
I see the mummy, Bride of Frankenstein, Frankenstein's monster, Dracula, Wolfman, and Creature from the Black Lagoon.
Hey, you know why I chose this?
Why?
It's Monster Monday.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah.
Speaking of Monster Monday, how's that shirt turning out for you?
Oh, this is an alien autopsy.
But yeah, we have a
blood. Tom for that.
You're not the fucking leader!
Tom had nothing to do with this.
Tom has everything to do with aliens.
I'm the leader.
Okay.
So tonight, what are we watching?
The 1922 silent film, Nosferatu.
Which we have been anticipating for a while.
Since 1946. But yeah, here it is over here. Good thing we have three copies of it. Nosferatu. 1922. I think we might be able to watch it with the turquoise tint. You ready?
I'm ready.
For Nosferatu.
Nosferatu.
All right. I'll be back with you shortly.
I'm on the floor, and I don't know if I'll be able, oh gosh, it's strobing. I don't know if you'll be able to see Drake, but actually I can see Drake.
So, thoughts?
One second, let me adjust this.
I am definitely let down. Watching this was more of a chore. I feel like it was more of a chore than
Well, that's something. Because it was a silent film.
Yeah, but I figured... I thought it was going to be more intriguing than it was. You're, like, facing it down. Do you able to see? Oh, all right.
I can see you.
But... The lack of audio definitely did not help, obviously.
This is for a time when you were supposed to read the book before you watched the movie.
I was about to say, the dialogue did not really help with showing you what was happening. There was a lot of random jump cuts and a lot of just things that just didn't make sense if you just go into it, I guess. If you watch it with more context or, like, you know, read the book, or I guess the original Dracula, you know, Universal Monster Dracula movie, if you watch that beforehand, I guess it follows the same story.
Yeah,
you kind of more what's going on. We did.
Yeah, ours, it definitely would have been a whole different viewing experience. Yeah, sorry about this. It would have been a whole different viewing experience had we seen the 1931 Bela Lugosi version of Dracula. I feel like we definitely would have been able to catch on more. Probably enjoy it a lot more. But, this is something we wanted to watch. I mean, all the scenes with Count Orlok were still very entertaining. Just because, like at the beginning when we were still like really focused in on it, we were making a whole bunch of jokes about like his fashion statements. I don't know. It got really funny though.
Yeah.
So
overall, not gonna lie, it's probably one of the most boring one we've seen that all the way through. But my ranking of it...
I still say Salem's Law.
My ranking of it definitely takes into consideration the time frame that it was made in. I don't really ever see myself rewatching it. Maybe at some point, if I get more context behind the story and stuff, maybe I'll see myself maybe watching it again.
That's when I would see myself. I wouldn't watch it again without context.
Yeah. But yeah, which is kind of interesting because the second movie we're watching in this video,
Dracula. Yeah, the one we should have watched first.
The one we should have watched first.
Well, am I upset that we've seen this? No, because I feel like a lot of kids from our generation have never seen this and will never watch it.
Nor will they ever know the name of Nosferatu.
Unless they watch that one episode of SpongeBob.
Yeah, which is what started this whole thing. Kind of just.
I feel like we're kind of familiar with the vampire, like, what it looked like.
Yeah. But, I mean,
Which I still think is creepier than most vampires you see nowadays.
The film itself, if you could usually easily use the film. Watching the movie is not creepy, but using the film in a different context could easily be used very creepily.
I feel like watching it in black and white also hurt it a little bit. I would have rather had, like, the blue tint.
Yeah, we weren't able to.
I'd rewatch it if I had context and I had the blue tint.
Yeah.
That'd be a whole different viewing experience.
I think it'd be interesting. Yeah.
Because I felt like the fact that it was in black and white kind of threw it off, because every time, like, I expect sound. Like, my brain is not in the thing, because we watch black and white movies with sound. But if I saw it with color, then I would have enjoyed it more.
Yeah, I mean, it's kind of hard to say, really. This was our, at least my first silent film that I actually watched, per se.
He fell asleep.
Yeah, I fell asleep.
Yeah. Oh, this actually looks really nice. This shot right here, you're like right between Halloween and Creature from the Black Lagoon.
Oh,
and like a little bit of Jaws is up there. I really like this shot. But yeah.
But
for what it is, I'll say it's an okay movie without... If I had context, I'd say it's probably good. For its time, it was really good, but it was okay. I mean, it is what it is. There's nothing we can do.
So yeah. Yeah, I mean... Definitely, since, you know, we come from a time where we see...
We're spoiled.
Yeah, we're spoiled when it comes to entertainment, theater, and stuff, and watching this, we're not really the artsy type that appreciate, like... I mean, we can appreciate old films to an extent.
Oh, we love them. Some of our favorites are old.
Yeah, this one was definitely way farther back than anything we've ever watched, so we just kind of have to, like...
Something we're not used to.
Yeah, we're not used to it. There's a chance that we could get into more of those, like, Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde type, you know, movie as well.
Phantom of the Opera! I'm kidding.
Phantom of the Opera.
Actually, they did take the silent version, and they added scenes in with sound.
Of Nosferatu?
No, of Phantom of the Opera. They took it, and then they went and re-recorded it 4 years after it came out. They got the same actors, and they reshot everything for sound. Minus the stuff with Lon Chaney, but, yeah.
He was dead.
No, because he signed a different contract. Yeah, that's all I have to say about this movie, but it was good.
So I still like Nosferatu as a
character
horror icon type of thing. His aesthetic and his look is cool. Movie, I don't know. I heard there's a remake, and then there's also like an AMC or FX series based off Nosferatu. It'd definitely be a completely different feel. It would be interesting to check out.
The remake actually sounds really interesting because it was made by, like, notable people
in
the horror community. So, yeah, that's it. I'm just going to end it. This is actually a really good cinematic shot right here.